Austria's chancellor giving new details about his tense face-to-face meeting with Russian President Vladimir Putin last week and warning about Putin's possible mindset amid the invasion.
I think he is now in his own war logic. You know, he thinks the war is necessary for security guarantees for the Russian Federation. He doesn't trust the international community. He blames the Ukrainians for genocide in the Donbas region. I think he believes he is winning the war.
How important is it to hear someone who has met with him and had a conversation with him to see what his mindset is, that regardless of what is being demonstrated or shown, he is certain that he is winning this war? How can that empower, that kind of information empower Ukraine or any of the allies trying to help Ukraine?
Well, Frederica, what it shows, I believe, is that Vladimir Putin is so isolated. He surrounded himself with yes men. And in fact, maybe even getting delusional. His forces have taken some terrible casualties. I mean, more casualties in 50 some odd days than they received in 8 years in the war in Afghanistan, as an example. They've had problems with logistics, they've had problems with command and control, and they've had so many soldiers who have been killed, wounded, or are missing. Either he is not getting those reports or he's ignoring that. So getting into his head, which is difficult, that's why NATO and the U.S. must take the strategic initiative and make Putin react to them as opposed to the opposite.
Historian Max Boot wrote in the Washington Post this week that many of the issues the Russian army have had historically, they are having again in Ukraine, including corruption, brutality, low morale, poor planning, faulty logistics, bad intelligence, lack of coordination between units, over-centralization, and a paucity of initiative on the part of junior officers and sergeants. If it is indeed, you know, history repeating itself with Russia, is there a way in which to anticipate the outcome or how this ends?
Well, what Max Boot said is all correct. When I was a multinational brigade commander in Kosovo, I had a Russian battalion, which demonstrated all those issues that Max Boot pointed out. But in this scenario, in this war in Ukraine, one thing that the Russians do still have, even with all their problems, is they still have capability and they have mass. We've seen this war, at least in eastern Ukraine, go on now for 8 years. I think we'll see more of that. The Russians will try a big push and they will be repelled, but they will still hold ground. So this war, if in fact the Ukrainians want to reclaim all of their lost territory, is going to take years.